Hello children, I welcome you all once again to your English class. I hope you all are doing well. Children, for today's English lesson, we are going to start a new chapter from your English supplementary reader book, An Alien Hand. And this chapter is the fourth chapter, The Cock and the Anthem by O. Henry. Yes, children, he is a very famous short story writer and he was from America. Okay, so you should also know his real name, which is William Sidney Potter. Okay, so this was his real name and this was his pen name. You should remember that this is his pen name. Many artists and many writers adopt for themselves a pen name, a name in which they write. Okay, because this is the real name. We can see he is called by O. Henry. In this market, in the literature field, he is known as O. Henry. But both are is the same people. Both are the same person. Okay. Now, in this chapter, which is on page number 20, starting from page number 20, we are going to read about a man. We are going to read about soul. We are going to peep into his life and we will see what we have to learn. Okay, so we are not talking about soap that we bathe with, we bath with. We are talking about a character named Soapy. Okay, so we have a character, Soapy. Okay, so he will be the center. He is the protagonist of the story. He is the hero of the story. Let's get started. Before you read, have you ever found yourself in a situation in which what happened was the opposite of what you expected? Yes, children. Sometime, or maybe it had happened with you, because it had happened with me. Sometimes we commit a great mistake, okay? We commit a great error and we fear, we are scared that we might be scolded for it and maybe bitten black and blue. But what happens is actually the opposite. Our parents come to know and they tell us nothing. They just explain, give a small explanation that you should not do this. Even in some cases, they do not do this and they are okay with it. Okay, so here also we will see that sometimes our overthinking may lead us to trouble, but we should avoid overthinking. Okay, we should not think before what has actually happened. We should let the time sink in. We should let the time decide what is going to happen. Let's get started. If so, you are familiar with the irony of the situation, which is often embarrassing. The story that you are going to read has a number of such situations. Let us get started. You can see this orange writing here, orange text. Let's see what it has told us that's going to happen in the story. Soapy is a homeless, jobless man. Yes, he doesn't have a job, he doesn't has a job, and then we can see that he is also homeless. He doesn't have a. Now, winter is fast approaching. Now imagine you don't have a roof on your head, right? You are not staying under any roof. Where will you go, right? What would you do? Because it's really freezing cold outside. Okay. Now the winters were approaching and Soapy must have a place to stay. Okay, he must get himself a place to stay because he is homeless. He has nothing to call his own. So what shall he do now? Okay. Soapy comes to a decision at last. Okay, he decides something for himself. Let's see what's his decision. Soapy moved restlessly on a seat in Madison Square. This is Madison Square is an area, okay, there. There are certain signs to show that winter is coming, okay. What are the signs? Because some signs are okay, like snow falling, people wearing coats, all these signs are common. Let's see what sign is O. Henry talking. Birds begin to fly south. Yes, children, because they are leaving the cold countries, they are migrating to warmer places. Why? Because the country will be freezing in some days, right? So they want to keep themselves warm and they don't want to survive. They don't want to die. So they have to migrate. So the birds are migrating. Now they are moving to south. People want new warm clothes. Okay, yes, people start buying warm clothes, winter clothes. And Soapy moves restlessly on his seat in the park. Okay, what is Soapy doing? Soapy is restless. Soapy is not doing anything. He is very restless. He doesn't know what to do because he doesn't have a home. He needs something upon his head. He needs to stay under something, right? Because otherwise he would die out in the cold. When you see these signs, you know that winter is near. He was sleeping or he was restlessly moving on his seat. A dead leaf fell at Soapy's feet. Okay, what do we see here? That because you know when autumn is there, leaves start falling. We can see that winter is approaching when the autumn arrives. With the arrival of autumn, we know that the dead leaves or the dried withered leaves start to fall. Yes, dried withered leaves start to fall. That was a special sign for him that winter was coming. It was time for all those who lived in Madison Square to prepare, because this is autumn. After this, the winter will be approaching and they have time. This time only they need to prepare themselves, get some warm clothes, get some brewing hot coffees, and they will be prepared for their, like, get some heater on, because in cold countries, you know, heaters are must because they are really cold places. Soapy's mind now realized that fact. The time had come. He had to find some way to take care of himself during the cold weather. And therefore, he moved restlessly on the seat. Now, when you are thinking a lot, yes, you are just not at ease with yourself. You are thinking a lot. You are calculating what I need to do, what I need to do with this, okay, with this situation. What do I need to do? Can you sleep peacefully? No, right? So here also we can see that Soapy was really restless. He could not be at ease. He was very restless. He was moving here and there on the seat. Soapy's hope for the winter were not very high, okay? He knew that he has to survive anyhow, but his hopes were not high. He was not thinking of sailing away on a ship, okay? Like the birds were migrating because they had their wings, Soapy could not do so. Even he was not thinking or he was not planning to go on a trip, right? Like I will go for a summer vacation or I will move to some countries which are warmer. He could not afford it. Okay, he was not planning to do this. He was not thinking of southern skies. Okay, because it was cold in this northern sky, northern hemisphere is cold enough. So now he is not also dreaming about southern skies where the birds have gone, or of the Bay of Naples. 3 months in the prison on Blackwell's Island was what he wanted. Okay, see, imagine. Who wants to go in a prison, right? Until and unless he or she is a criminal, even a criminal doesn't want to visit a cell, a jail, right? A prison. But he wanted to go where? He wanted to get himself a room in the prison. Now let's see why it is. 3 months of food every day and a bed every night. See, such basic necessity is not met. He just want food and a bed for himself, okay? Like 3 months will be really tough for him because these 3 months are going to be cold, right? Winter will last for at least these 3 months. And he is thinking that I don't need to worry about food and bed. He wants to get himself in prison, okay? In jail. 3 months safe from the cold north wind and safe from cops. Yes, you know, especially we know that these people who are homeless, they are always driven away from where they are staying, right? You have seen this condition of the poor people. They do not have a home, and the cops, the police, okay, they always want to what? Send them away. They just want them to drive them away from wherever they are patrolling, okay? wherever they are going with their jeeps, they want these homeless people to leave from that place. So he wanted himself safe from the cops as well. That is what Soapy wanted most in the world. Can you imagine that he is thinking all these things? No one wants to visit a prison, not even in their dreams. But Soapy has no choice because he is homeless. Okay? For years, Blackwell's Island had been his winter home. He always arranges his stay in the Blackwell's Island. Okay, this island, there is a prison there. Okay, this place has a prison, and we can see that Soapy visits his first home every winter because he has nowhere to go. Richard's New Yorkers made their plans to go to Florida or to the shore of Mediterranean Sea each winter because they are warmer places. So rich, when we are talking about rich Europeans, when we are talking about rich New Yorkers, the people from New York are New Yorkers, of course. So they made their plans to Florida because Florida is a warmer country, right? It's a warmer place. So they want to visit Florida. But here is Soapy, who is planning to get himself into a prison. Soapy made his small plans for going to the island because there he will have 3 months of free food, 3 months of staying safe from the cold winds, 3 months free bed, right? And now the time had come. Okay, the winter is approaching, so the time has come. He has to do something so that the cops can put him there. Okay, 3 big newspapers under his coat and some over his legs had not kept him warm during the night in the park. Okay, so see how he has arranged his warm clothes. He has got himself what? He stuffed himself. He put it inside his coat. Under his coat, he put 3 what? Big newspapers. He stuffed it in, and also on his legs. He just put the newspapers on his legs. See, so pathetic condition, right? So poor he is that he cannot afford some good warm clothes. So he observed, he noticed that it wasn't enough. These stuffing of newspapers would do him no good. He thought to himself that these newspapers are not going to work for him. So Soapy was thinking of the island because he had already spent a night in the park and he felt really cold. Okay, so this was not at all. Let's see now what happens. So Soapy was thinking of the island. There were places in the city where he could go and ask for food and a bed. This would be given to him. So he was sure that if he knew about some places that those which offered food and bed, okay, he would easily get it. He could move from one building to another and he would be taken care of through the winter. But he liked Blackwell's Island better. Okay, we see that this man is liking a jail. He is fond of the prison because he has spent so many days there. So he knows that because in winter, you know, there are some shelters for the homeless. They can easily go there and get a bed and food, and they do not need to worry about anything else. But the preference we can see Soapy had was what? The Blackwell's Island, because yes, he felt really content there. He felt really satisfied there, happy there. Soapy's spirit was proud. Okay, his spirit was high. He was proud. If he went to any of these, there were certain things he had to do. Yes, children, you know, right? So you won't be given anything free. We don't get anything free of cost. We need to work for certain things like for food and for a bed. He needs to work. He needs to do certain things. In one way or another, he would have to pay for what they gave him. So see, either labor or cash. Okay. So if I'm paying you money, I don't need to do anything for you, right? But what if I'm not paying you money and you make me do certain things? So Sophie thought that why should I go there? They will ask me to do anything. If they are not taking money directly, they are taking my services, they are taking my labor. They would not ask him for money, but they would make him wash his whole body. Okay, so what is the task that he doesn't want to do? He doesn't want to bath. Do you see that what he doesn't want to do? He doesn't want to take a shower. Okay, he doesn't want to bath. They would make him answer questions. Okay, they will ask questions. He'll have to answer the questions. They would want to know everything about his life, and Sophie does not want to share it. Okay, they will query that where did you leave, where did you go, what happened to your mother or father with your parents, do you have brothers? Sophie did not want to answer all these questions, he wanted just to skip it. And in Blackwell's Island, no one is going to question him, no one is going him to take a shower, no one is going to tell him to take a shower. So he will be happy in the Blackwell's Island being himself. No, prison was better than that. The prison had rules that he would have to follow. Yes, all prison, all institutions have certain rules that you have to follow. But in prison, a gentleman's own life was still his own life. Okay, that means you do not need to do anything that you do not wish to do. Okay, so he thought that in prison, a gentleman will be allowed to live his own life. He doesn't have to do what pleases everyone else. He just needs to do what he wants. Now, Sophie, having decided to go to the island, at once began to move towards his desire. Sophie does his best to be on the wrong side of the law. He tries three tricks, all in vain. The fear that no cop will ever catch him makes him sick at heart. There were many easy ways of doing this. Now, there were some easy ways, there were some hard ways. Okay, he wanted to go to the prison, he will have to do something, right? So let's see what he thinks of. The most pleasant way was to go and have a good dinner at a fine restaurant. See, we now get the ideas of Sophie. He is thinking to go to a restaurant, fine restaurant, expensive one, the 5-star ones, and then eat proper dinner there. Then he would say that he had no money to pay, and then a cop would be called, a policeman would be called, a cop would be called. He would all be done very quietly. The cop would arrest him. He would be taken to a judge. The judge would do the arrest. This is one way, okay? So he left his seat and walked slowly out of Madison Square. Now he wants to leave and go to the fine restaurant, because he has a plan to follow, to the place where the great street called Broadway and Fifth Avenue meet. Okay, there was a very posh restaurant in this place where these two places meet, like Broadway and Fifth Avenue meet. So he went across this wide space and started north on Broadway. Now he wants to go to Broadway. He stopped at the large and brightly lighted restaurant. Okay, he has to execute his plan. He has to meet his plan. So what does he decide to do? Okay, let's see. He stopped at a large and brightly lighted restaurant. This was where the best food and the best people in the best clothes appeared every evening. Okay, that means the richer class, the richer section of the society usually preferred this place to have their evening meal. Okay. Sophie believed that above his legs he looked alright. Okay. So that means the problem was with his lower body. With his upper body he was looking fine. His face was clean, okay, he was shaven. His coat was good enough. If he could get to a table, he believed that success would be his. okay, because when you are sitting on a table, your lower part of the body is not visible, okay. So we see there that Sophie thought that I should at least reach to the table and just sit on the table so that only my upper portion of the body is visible, okay. Now the part of him that could be seen above the table would look all right. The waiter would bring him what he asked for. So the waiter would definitely bring him whatever he orders, because you know, sometimes your dress also matters to the places you want to visit. Like you cannot you do not want to go decked up to a hospital, and you do not go to a wedding ceremony with plain clothes, right? So you need to be dressed for an occasion. To visit places, you need to be dressed accordingly. The waiter would bring him what he asked for. He began thinking of what he would like to eat. He now wants to recall some fancy dishes name so that he can order in the restaurant. In his mind, he could see the whole dinner. Yes, today he is going to have a proper meal for himself. And he's also going to be sent to where? Blackwell's Island, because he's going to do this thing. The cost would not be too high. He did not want the restaurant people to feel any real anger. Yes. So he thought that I would be ordering items which will be moderately costly, okay? But the dinner would leave him filled and happy for the journey to his winter home. So the dinner would make him happy. But as Sophie put his foot inside the restaurant door, the head waiter saw his broken old shoes. So the when he was entering the door, he saw, means actually who found him? The head waiter saw his old torn shoes, okay, and the torn clothes that covered his legs. Strong and ready hands, means he just held him and turned him around and moved him quietly and quickly outside of it. So here Sophie had a bad luck. He could not enter the restaurant. He was just shooed away by the head waiter. Sophie turned off Broadway. Now he left Broadway. It seemed that this most easy way to the island was not to be his. He must think of some other way of getting there. Okay? So he thought that this was not a good plan. Now I have to do something. At a corner of 6th Avenue was a shop with a wide glass window, bright with electric lights. Okay, now he thought I need to go somewhere else. There was a shop which had a very wide, means greater in width, window was of great dimension, that it was in great width, bright with electric lights. Yes, you know, fancy places have lots and lots of light, fancy lights. Sophie picked up a big stone and threw it through the glass. Now what did he do? He just picked up a huge stone and then he just flung it towards the glass window. Yes. Now let's see what happens then. People came running around the corner. People from all over the place, the area, came and crowded there. Okay, they just looked at the window. A cop was the first among them. So what Sophie wanted was here a real cop, a policeman. Sophie stood still. He did not move because he wanted to get arrested. He did not move from that, and he smiled when he saw the cop. Yes, come in because I want you. Yes. Where's the man that did that? Asked the cop. Yes. Now he is looking for the man who broke the glass panes, right? Who broke the glass window. Now he is looking for the man. Don't you think that I might have done it? He said, what? That don't you think I have done it? What are you thinking? What are you supposing I have done it? Said Sophie. He was friendly and happy. Now whoever has done this, why would he smile? He would feel guilty, he would feel scared, he would fear and run away from there. But he was smiling and he was very friendly with the cop. What he wanted was coming towards. But the cop's mind would not consider Sophie. Men who break windows do not stop there to talk to cops. Yes, children, so this is a fact that if you are doing something wrong, if you are guilty, you will run away from that place. You won't stay there and talk to policemen, right? Okay, the cops saw a man that they run away as fast as they can. The cops saw a man further along the street running. Now, to the disappointment of Sophie, there was a man, running very fast as he could. And so the cop saw that, yes, this is the culprit because he is running away. So I must hold him, I must catch him. And Sophie, sick at heart, he thought, I planned this whole thing and he is now going and catching someone else. He is going after someone else. Walked slowly away. Now this plan also backfired. It did not work. He had failed two times in the same night. He had failed now. Across the street was another restaurant. We can see there was another restaurant. It was not so fine as the one on the Broadway. The people who went there were not so rich. They were middle class. The people who went there were not so rich. Its food was not so good. Into this, Sophie took his old shoes and his torn clothes. And no one stopped him, He sat down at the table and was soon eating a big dinner. When he had finished, he said that he had no money. He ate all the dinner, fine dinner he ate. And he said, I have no money. Get busy and called a cop. He said, now, so Sophie said, now you must call a cop. Go and call a cop because I don't have money. I don't have money to pay. And don't keep a gentleman waiting. That means please call a cop as soon as possible. No cop for you, said the waiter. He called another waiter. The two waiters threw Sophie upon his left ear on the hard street house. Now see, he said, we are not calling cops for you. The waiter, he called another waiter and both of them threw Sophie where? Outside the restaurant. That means through the door he went and he was thrown with his, he fell on his left ear and he was thrown on the street. He was thrown in the street, Now let's see, he stood up slowly. One part at a time. He stood up slowly, very slowly, and one by one means one part at a time, and bit the dust from his clothes. Because obviously he has fallen on the street, now he is dusty. So he just dusted away his clothes, beat the dust. That means beat the dust is a phrase used for saying that he removed the dirt from his clothes. Prison seemed only a happy dream now. Now it's looking like a dream to him. The island seemed very far away. Because when you dream, you want to get it, but sometimes dreams are not that easily available to you, easily obtainable. A cop who was standing near laughed and walked away. A cop, when he saw that he was thrown and he now dusted away the dirt, then the cop laughed and just went away. He did not say him anything. He did not catch him. Now, Sophie started moving again. When he stopped, he was near several theatres. In this part of the city, streets are brighter and hearts are more joyful than in other parts. Women and men in rich warm coats moved happily in the winter air. Okay, now the struggle was real. When you see that some people are privileged, they are wearing fine warm clothes and they are enjoying the winter. When you are homeless, you are jobless, you don't have coats to keep you warm in that harsh winter, you are suffering, you are struggling, okay? And some people are privileged. So you do what? You feel sorry for yourself. A sudden fear caught Sophie. No cop was going to arrest him. Okay, he thought that I am not going to be arrested today. No one is going to arrest me. So children, with this, I will end my lesson for this day here only. We are going to learn about Sophie, what happens with Sophie in our next video lesson. Till then, children, please take care of yourself and have a great day. Bye-bye.